Walt
Rowengartner?
Rowengartner.
That makes no sense, but
you said Roy Dynamite.
Oh,
Walt.
I got you.
I mean, Walt Rookie of the Year. Walt of the Year.
Walt Pie.
Rookie Disney.
All right.
That's what I played. I played Walt Disney as a rookie.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Now that's out of the way.
Right. So, if you guys aren't aware, in case they don't know what references we're making, in the movie Walt Before Mickey, which you can go and watch on Netflix, Tom plays Walt Disney, and John plays Roy Disney. So that's where we're making the references from. So.
Did you all already know that?
Yeah.
You've passed the first trivia question.
I had a no over here. So not everyone.
That's good. That no was on John's team. That's fine by me.
Okay. So you were the lead of that movie, not me.
So basically, as I ask questions, we're going to see what they know, and then we're going to bring some people up to be a part of the team. And if you answer some questions right, I have some Mickey ears and some books, and then, like I said, we're going to have one grand prize winner that gets what Clint's going to draw.
If you answer any incorrectly, you won't be live anymore. You will be dead.
I'm trying not to block people or the cameras.
So. That's a hammer.
Did I, when you weren't listening to me talk about the live Facebook page, did I not listen to you introduce Clint?
Correct.
Oh, so you already introduced him?
I did.
Okay,
I talked about him before you guys came
Perfect.
Out, and I introduced him, and I said what he was doing. And I also said that he's upstairs and
so
they can come visit him later.
What's Clint's deal? Whose team is he on? We've never done this with Clint.
Yeah, Clint's not on either team. He's not on either team. Oh. He's going to draw something that the audience can win. And also, at one point, each of you get one chance to call on Clint because Clint knows a lot about Disney.
Oh, he's a lifeline?
He's a lifeline.
Lifeline! Someone explain that to me.
You are our last hope. Obi-Wan and Chris. Which is
then you're all in trouble.
Disney now, so
one time Tom can call on you, and one time John can call on you. If nobody in the audience knows,
what if I don't know?
Then they.
It's like Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Call a friend, and then sometimes the friend doesn't know.
Yeah, you're the friend who may or may not know. You can say whatever you want. I mean, if you don't want to help them, you can lie. I'm not going to stop you. All right, let's get started. So, who was the first Disney feature character to speak directly to the audience? You know what I'm talking about? Where they,
this is from a feature film?
This is Disney feature character.
Wait, so are we just both answering the question? Is it just like, or we hit a buzzer, like we know it first? What's going on?
No, like we always do. We'll come up with, we'll separate to our own quorums and we'll figure out what our answer is, then we'll give her the answer. And we could both be right, but probably not. Just me. First Disney feature character.
To speak directly to the audience.
Break the fourth wall, huh?
That's where you break the fourth wall and you talk like, hey, can you believe these guys are being like this right now?
Does anyone on my team know?
I thought this was an easy question.
My team
is that a answer to this?
I've got some hands. All right, so I've got this guy in the green hat. What do you think it is? Okay, you've got a Mickey Mouse from your side.
Boy, that was a real deep cut there, Mickey Mouse.
Stranger Things, what do you think? Steamboat Willie.
Steamboat Willie, I don't believe, was a character.
Yeah, that's a movie.
Well, he also didn't
speak. Or maybe it was. Hey, what was Steamboat? There's the name of the cartoon.
What do you got?
Is that a character?
He whistled.
I can't, sorry. We got Jiminy, you got a Jiminy Cricket over here.
That's a good one. I like that one. That was on my team, right?
Yeah, but
anybody
on
like my team?
The first character ever.
Can you give us a hint? Was this breaking of the fourth wall, talking to the audience in a feature film, or was it like one of their side cartoons? Can you even answer that?
I think it was in a feature film, but I'm actually not.
It doesn't say, it just says.
Yeah, I didn't anticipate you would ask this question.
Well, yeah, let me see it and I'll let you know, and then I'll come up with my answer.
Okay.
What do you think, sir, on my team? What do you think?
Genie from Aladdin.
Oh, that's a good one, too.
I don't know if it's a character.
Too late. One more on John's side, and then you're going to get the answers. What do you think, sir?
You're not
talking
to the audience.
Yeah, you. Who?
Disney. It's Disney now. He is not wrong.
Yeah, but it's not. Wrong. But it says first character.
No.
First character.
I feel like character.
Was that the 1920s character. Deadpool?
Feature character covers like Pluto, Goofy. Those are proper like. Created only for Disney, I feel like.
All right, you guys have to give an answer.
All right. Jiminy Cricket was pretty good. What do you guys feel? Are you Jiminy Cricket?
Oh, all right,
our answer is what's our vote
Cricket.
Over here?
Mickey!
Are we going to go with
Deadpool?
Mickey! Are we going with Mickey Mouse or are we going with Jiminy Cricket?
Jiminy!
Wait,
raise your hands for Mickey Mouse on my team. Raise your hands for Jiminy Cricket on my team.
Oh, so, all right, so I guess we're allowed to have the same answer. Is that allowed?
That actually came from my side, that suggestion, just so you know.
Yeah, okay.
I think
you guys suck.
Sure, I think you know, we're not towards the end we'll have to, you know, but right now.
Okay, what's the answer?
It is Jiminy Cricket. Congratulations.
Oh! Good job, dude. Yeah, but we all felt it, so
It's true. All right.
That's my team's point.
So,
I'll give it to you.
Gus from Cinderella had a real name. Do you know what it is?
Gustifer? No, not my official.
Yeah, who said Jiminy Cricket, by the way?
The first
original person that said Jiminy Cricket. Come on up, I have some ears for you. I think that deserves ears. Gus from Cinderella. Okay, what do you think over here?
Octavius.
Okay, we have an
Octavius. Tom, if you guys can go down to the audience and talk to your team as well.
Is that a guess or you know?
I was trying to make sure that our
I know.
My team member that said just agreed got a prize. I did not hear the question.
Oh, what is Gus from Cinderella's real name?
Alan. Hey, Rapunzel. What?
Yeah, we have the same
pretty
answer.
Sure, it's Octavius. All right, so we're having some pretty strong. I like Augustus, but that seems like obvious. And it was a guess.
It was
a guess from the heart. And I'm going to take a leap of faith. We're going with Augustus.
We're going with Octavius.
Yeah!
No, we do this for the love, not the point. A different guess?
So
how do you know that?
So, John, you're going to go.
I know you put your phones away. No Googling, you guys.
Yeah, no Googling. If I catch you with your phone.
Oh, she's Google up here. Okay. So, Octavius, what? I'm loving Augustus. I'm going with Augustus.
So you're going to go against what Rapunzel said.
Well, not just, don't single her out. Everybody else said Octavius.
Okay. So, Tom, you are correct. It is Octavius.
Well, I have to give credit to my team. Who was the first one that said that over here? There was a bunch of people saying it to me.
We normally get
someone that wants to take first credit. Like five of you were like, Octavius.
All right, so.
Door prize. I tried to steal from a kid. It didn't work. All right, good job.
That's
it's
not,
2-0.
It's not nice to steal from kids.
Well, I didn't do it, so.
Okay.
My whole house just dies. All right.
So, Pluto was originally the dog of what character, and what was Pluto's original name?
I feel like we covered this already.
Do you got it?
The original was Goofy.
Yeah, guess it.
Owner was Goofy.
Pluto had a different name originally. I'll give you a hint.
That's my guess.
I'm going to give you a little bit of a history lesson for those that don't know. The first movie that Pluto showed up in, he didn't even have a name, and there was two of him. It was a movie called The Chain Gang in 1930, and he was just a random bloodhound. And then he showed up in another movie, and he was he belonged to a character, and he had a different name other than Pluto. And it wasn't until the third movie that he showed up in, and he was actually Pluto.
Okay, so
Clint, do you know this?
We have a pretty
good. Does anyone know his original name?
Pluto had a different name originally.
Tell me this
and he was from a different movie. Do you know the answer?
And
do you know his name?
Don't say it. Just tell me if you know.
I got another. Yes. I got another guess on that same thing.
So Pluto, tell me this.
Anyone got the guess on the original name on my team?
It's not Pluto. This is not a trick question.
And it is a name.
He was in a movie without a name. I'm not talking about that. He came back in a second movie. He belonged to a famous Disney character. He belonged to a famous Disney character.
Okay, we got our first answer. Second one, I'm just going to... Do you have a guess? Do you have an answer for the second one?
Yeah, anyone? What? Someone raise their hand over here? Did I run over here for nothing?
Tom, have you got any guesses over there?
We're going with, he was, originally the owner was Goofy, and his name was Bruno.
Okay.
That's what we're guessing with.
All right.
Do you guys feel good about that?
No, Minnie! Yeah. Minnie Mouse!
Minnie Mouse?
We got it.
Oh, okay. We're going to change, okay. I'm being called an audible.
Okay, I got it.
All right, what?
Okay, so he was originally owned by Goofy.
Okay.
And his original name was Rover.
Okay. And what
I got another thumbs up, okay.
All right, what are you saying? I better not see any phones
out. You know that for sure. You're calling the audible.
Well, for the Minnie Mouse, yes.
Okay.
His name?
Okay. So we're going Minnie Mouse. And...